There is a word found in the 9th chapter of the Gospel as recorded by St. Luke. The 9th chapter of the Gospel as recorded by St. Luke. Amen. Some of you looked like you rested well last night. Amen. That you slept well and got an extra hour of sleep. Amen. Amen. Some of you needed it. Amen. Amen. The 9th chapter of the Gospel is reported by St. Luke. When you found it, we ask that you might stand to your feet and give honor to the reading of God's holy and divine word. Amen. Beginning in the 57th verse, we find these words. As they were walking along the road, a man said to him, I will follow you wherever you go. Jesus replied, foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man have no place to lay his head. And he said to another man, follow me. But the man replied, Lord, first let me go and bury my father. And Jesus said to him, let the dead bury their own, but you should go and proclaim the kingdom of God. Still another said, I will follow you, Lord, but first let me go back and say goodbye to my family. And Jesus replied, no one who puts his hand to the plow and looks back is fit for the service in the kingdom of God. I want to preach this morning from the thought, the abuses of excuses. The abuses of excuses. Gracious and eternal God, our Father, bless now this word and the manifestation of your word, O God, to the man of God. We pray, God, that you may continue to bless us in a mighty and a marvelous way. In Jesus' name, for Christ's sake, and all of the children of God, say amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Most of us have discovered in life that we can oftentimes find excuses when and where we really don't want to do something. Amen. And then we also discover when we want to do something, amen, we can find a way to do just what we want to do when we want to do it. Amen. I mean, I can remember when we were in the world. Amen. We wanted to do something. And we would jump through hoops and everything to get it done. Amen. If there was a party, there was no amount of snow that could stop us from getting to it. Amen. If we had to shove our way down the driveway, amen. And catch a cab or catch a ride or whatever we had to do, we had to push the car and down the street and just to get out of beyond the snowbanks, amen, we'll get there. Amen. There was no amount of rain. It didn't matter how hard it was raining. Amen. We were going to unbundle to match our outfits. Amen. But we will get out of that house and we were going to get to wherever we had to go. Amen. Amen. Whatever club, whatever house party, whatever hotel, motel, Holiday Inn, amen. Amen. We were going to get there. Amen. Amen. We weren't going to make any kind of excuse. But I find it strange that in the Church of the Living God that when it rained, amen, some of us can't even get to church. Amen. We passed our trap, but it was raining so hot. Amen. Why are you just looking down at the club that was raining so hot? Amen. Amen. Anything can stop us. Pastor, I was coming, but it was, when I got to the door, I noticed there was a running red stocking. Amen. When you want to go anywhere else, you put a little nail polish on and step over getting up. Amen. Amen. I grew a fast sister. I know all the secrets. Amen. Amen. Huh? Pastor, I wanted to come, but I just couldn't get my hair right. Well, you throw your gallows head on everywhere else. When you want to go, amen. 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 And most of us got weeds and weeds for every day of the week. We got a Monday weed, a Sunday weed, a Thursday weed. Amen. Amen. You got more weeds than you got AIDS. Amen. Hello, somebody. But Jesus said, my question said, as they were walking along the road, a man said, I will follow you over your road. And Jesus said, foxes have holes and birds of the air have nests, for the Son of Man has no place to lay his head. What I want to talk to you about this morning, some three things. I want you to understand that in order to serve God, if you're really serious about serving God, God has to take precedence and priority over and in your life.
Amen.
That means that God has to be first and foremost.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Well, most of us want God to stop doing whatever he's doing when we want God to come and see about us. God, I'm in trouble. God, I need your help. God, whatever you're doing, I need your help. Not tomorrow, but I need your help right now. And we don't want God to make any excuses. Amen. So first, God has to have priority over your flesh. Let me say it again. God has to have priority over your flesh. See, life will consume you with taking care of your flesh. But the thing that I've taught you and I really want you to understand is that no matter what you do, you can never, ever, never, ever, ever, never, ever satisfy your flesh. The more you do for your flesh, the more your flesh wants you to do.
Amen.
Amen. Look at what we even had though. Amen. No matter how much you eat, and that's an exaggeration, but how many of you just got through eating? And you full. And you go in the kitchen and still looking for something to eat. You, when you're in the living room, you just got to talk about how full you were. And by the time you get to the kitchen, I just need some sweetness. Amen. Because your flesh is never, ever, never, ever satisfied. If you don't control your flesh will always control you. That's why it's important, amen. That's why it is important that oftentimes we take a break from our flesh and we fast.
Amen.
Because fasting is really about learning how to discipline your flesh. Amen.
Yeah.
I told you you can buy a new car and be driving in the street. And your flesh is supposed to be sitting satisfied with the new car you in, and you go past another car and say, I like that one better. Why? Because your flesh is never satisfied. Amen. You got to control it. You got to make sure that God is have prerogative over your flesh. Paul said, I have to crucify my flesh daily. You can't give your flesh everything it wants when it wants it. You're going to learn how to say no to your flesh. You got clothes in your closet that you'll never worn because you can't say no to your flesh. Stop hanging up with the tag still on in your closet that you can't even fit no more. Because you bought it when you were such and such size. And that was 2 years and 20 pounds ago. I wish I was lying. Amen. But because God does not have priority over our flesh. So how do you get priority over your flesh? You fast. You make your flesh subject to you rather than you subject to your flesh. Amen. You don't just, now I'm not just talking about fasting from food, but you gotta fast from TV sometimes. Sometimes you get up and you go to the living room and you pull it and you say I'm just gonna sit here for 20 minutes and you get 4 hours later. Come on, you done sat there, you done watched Jerry Springer, you done watched Marvin Show, you done watched The View, you done watched this, and you're down on 4 hours on that. And you talking about where all my time gone? Your flesh has caused you to sit there and consume stuff, consume. Because you don't even have the strength or the power to say no and get up and do what you need to do. Amen. Amen. I'm in somebody's living room. Y'all get mighty quiet on me this morning. Amen. Amen. He said, another man, follow me. But the man replied, Lord, first let me go bury my father. Jesus said, let the dead bury their own, but you go proclaim the kingdom of God. Amen. Not only does God have to have priority over your flesh, but God also has to have priority over your family.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Sometimes it's your family telling you.
Amen.
You spend too much time down at that church. You just everything you got going on down there. You just gotta be there, yeah. Because I see it as an outlet and an opportunity for me to serve God.
Amen.
See, you gotta understand that sometimes the haters that's after you is in your family. Why? Because most folk always compete with who God is.
All right. Amen.
But God has to be priority over you. You people, you should love your family, but make God first. No, I can't do that. I won't be there because God, I need to be in place and in position because I'm on post at my church. I'm doing something for God. It is a service to God. And don't compromise your service to God. How many times have you been on your job? And the boss, you go to walk out the door, and the boss says, look, I need you a couple more hours, can you stay? And you'll stop and you'll stay.
Amen.
And you may be working for all the time, you may be working for just a few more ducats, whatever you call them. But how I'm not saying not to make family important. I'm not saying family is not significant, because family is important. Family is significant. But nothing or no one is more significant and important than God. What does God want from you? The Bible said that God wants a reasonable service from you. That the sacrifice you make is to God. Amen. I surrendered my life to God so that I might serve Him. Amen. Stop making excuses as to why you can't do what God has called you to do. Amen. God designed and made us that we might be of a service to Him. He made us that we might give the glory unto Him. So what you got to be to say in your daily walk is, how is what I'm doing here is going to be a service to God? How is this situation or what I'm doing going to glorify God? Is anybody getting this?
Amen.
Last. Amen. Still another said, I will follow you, Lord, but first let me go back and say goodbye to my family. And Jesus said, replied, no one who puts his hand to the plow and looks back is fit for the service of God. God has to have priority over your friends. Be careful about getting involved with people that want to interfere with your relationship with God. For people that get mad when you spend time with God. Be careful about folks that want to call you up on Friday, Sunday morning, talking about, baby, let's go shopping. Amen. People that want to interfere when you try to get to a quiet practice or quiet rehearsal. Or when you're doing anything and turn into a servant of God, all of a sudden they want to pull you away from living a disciplined life for God. Because what that person is really doing, that person is trying to sabotage your relationship with God, whether you realize it or not. If and when you want a relationship with God, you've got to make God first. Why? Because God said, I am what kind of God is that?
Jealous.
A jealous God. Amen. You know what jealousy is? Come a bit. Come a bit.
You gotta stay in one place if I
can. That's right. Come on. Come here. What you looking at, Mark? You looking at Mark? Huh? Huh? That's what jealousy is. Amen. That's what jealousy is. Amen. Jealousy has a temperament. God says, I'm a jealous. That means God is saying to you that when you spend more time with other things and other people than you spend with Him, God said, I don't like that. God said, when your mind or your attention is given towards something or some of that, God said, I don't like that. God said, I want to be first and foremost in your life. I'm just going to let you know that you got to make God first. that he wants to be in an intimate relationship with you. He wants to be in a relationship with me. He wants to be the first thing you think about in the morning. And the last thing you think about at night. Amen. He wants to be the one that when you're having problems and trials and tribulations, he wants you to call on him. He wants you to text so-and-so. He wants you to call so-and-so. God said, I want you to call on me. And I want you to trust and believe that I can do whatever it is that you ask me to do. Amen. You tired of your so-called friends and family turning you down? Trust God. You say he doesn't have it? I started to let you know that he has a cattle of 1,000 people. That all the silver and gold belongs to him. Anything that you need, God's somebody got it.
Amen.
When I trusted people, friends and family, life was ahead. Amen. It wasn't until I learned how to trust God. Now, I'm not saying God won't operate through family and friends, because he'll do that.
Yes, he will.
He'll make somebody give you that last dime. Amen. He'll make somebody have compassion and love for you. Amen. But it's all because of your relationship with him. I've come this morning because there's somebody who wants a closer walk with God. But not only that, but God wants a closer walk with you. And God is saying to you this morning, if you want to be closer to me, take that step. If you draw not to me, I'll draw not to you. Take that step. And surrender all that you have to him. Whatever you need, God's got it. Let us all stand. The doors of the church are open right now. If there's one who knows not the Lord and the Father, that you see him. One who yet has surrendered your life to Jesus. Won't you come right now?